Welcome back to another video in our dashboard series. In this video, we will see how to create and configure period over period gadget in the PME web client. Let's get started. This gadget shows consumption data for the same measurement for two different viewing periods side by side. In this example, the information is shown in a column chart, but this gadget supports the stacked column, line with markers, and points chart type. This gadget can help in making informed decisions to optimize energy usage and improve overall efficiency. This gadget supports target line. Let's walk through the process of configuring the gadget. In the PME web client, go to dashboard menu. Add a new dashboard option. Once the dashboard is named, proceed by clicking on add gadget. Enter period keyword and search. Only period over period gadget is visible on the screen. Select period over period gadget and click on next button. After providing a title for the gadget, such as period over period, and choosing the desired level of opacity, proceed to the next step. At this stage, you have the option to customize the font, precision, and color. Proceed to the next step. For now, we'll skip show data points, chart color, and watermark and come back to it later. But for now, proceed to the next step. Adding the data series. This gadget supports hierarchies. There are dedicated videos to learn more about hierarchies, allowing you to choose the sources from individual devices or groups of hierarchies. In this case, I will take the areas from the hierarchy. Make sure to check your show advanced that the checkbox was displayed only the measurements with historical data is selected. Select your measurement. Remember, you can also customize the display name and units. You can also customize series style. Proceed to the next step. Period over period is the type of gadget where you cannot choose more than one source. You need to go to the next step where you specify the time range. Multiple time ranges are available in the drop-down menu. You can select this week over last week. View your data aggregation info. Select today over yesterday. Based on the instance, the data aggregation info will be different. For this instance, choose this month over last month and in the aggregation select by day. Click on next button. We'll see later usage of left axis title, max and min value in the chart. Now drop down on chart type and choose your chart type. Select column chart. Proceed to the next step. We'll see later about purpose of add target line. Click on finish button. Check the result. Compare and analysis the data between this month over last month. Go to Edit Chart. Go to Chart Settings. Enable Show Data Points to show your value on the chart. And enable Watermark to display a watermark text on the chart. The purpose of watermarking text is to create a translucent image or text on the paper to provide authenticity. Type the required text. And select the alignment and font size of the text from the available choices in the drop-down menus. Save the settings. Check the result. Data points and watermark text are visible in the chart. Go to Edit Chart. Select Chart Settings. Disable Show Data Points. Disable Watermark. Save the settings. Check the result. Data points and watermark text are not visible. Go to Edit Chart. Select Axis Settings. Enter a title for a left axis. Under Left Axis Only, axis titles will appear in the gadget. Select Fixed Option for the max value and min value for the axis. Enter the fixed maximum value for the axis. By default, fixed min value is 0. But you change the min value for the axes. Save the settings and check the result. Left axis title, max and min value is appeared in the left axis. Go to Edit Chart. Select Axis Settings. If you select Auto, maximum value is automatically adjusted based on available data for the selected measurement. If you select Auto, minimum value is automatically adjusted based on available data for the selected measurement. Save the settings and check the result. Whenever the data or time period changes, the axis automatically calculates data scale and sets axis minimum and maximum values in the chart. Go to Edit Chart. Select Axis Settings. Change the chart type from column to stacked column. Now the chart type is changed from column to stacked column. Select the chart type based on your requirement. Go to Edit Chart. Change back the chart type to column. Select Target Line. Click on Add Target Line. A target line is a horizontal line drawn on the chart that represents an ideal value, such as goal or threshold or average or minimum value. Select Fixed Target to specify how the target line is applied. Enter target line value. Based on this value, the horizontal target line is plotted on the graph. Use the color selector to choose the color of the target line. Enter the label for the target line. Target line will be plotted on left axis only. Save the settings. Target line is appeared on the chart based on entered target value in the target line settings. Go to Edit Chart. Select target line settings. Click on Remove Target Line icon to delete the target line. Save the settings. Now the target line is removed from the chart. Thank you for watching.